Hey everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Air Hauler 2 with Mimi Herd 37. So, I had this Caitlin Wright. She's been doing some jobs, and she just moved the Piper Cherokee over to KOXD, Miami University Airport over in Oxford, Ohio. And in this episode, we're going to go over there and fly that thing back down to Huntington. We got about 396 pounds of potatoes, so it's a light one. Kind of nice to have the light one in that plane. We get used to flying that. It's only about 124 miles, so it should be a pretty quick flight. I'm not going to do all the procedures or everything for this. It's a complete crosswind on both runways, so I figure when we get to Huntington, we'll just hit up ATIS and see what runway is in use and do it that way. So let's go over here, and well, I guess we can just go ahead and fly it. It's already there. I just loaded it up. Plane is 100%. Man, I tell you what, the AI pilots, they fly our 172 Skyhawk on those passenger flights, and they are absolutely just destroying that plane. It's really kind of pissing me off. I've spent so much money. We're actually losing money on those because they're just destroying the plane. It's ridiculous. Anyhow, I've got 14 gallons of fuel loaded up. The potatoes are already on board. All right. Switch this over to VFR, although it really doesn't matter. And we'll fly, I don't know if that's more east or south. It kind of looks more south, so we'll say 6,500 feet. Move the time back a little bit. And we don't want to go to last position because I didn't fly it there, and we saw what happened last time. So I'll just go over here to the ramp number two. And with that, we'll go ahead and move on over to the plane. Alright everybody, here we are at the plane. Got everything loaded, the fuel and the weight and all that good stuff. Here at our plane, right there is going to be the runway. I believe that's runway 23 in that heading. I wish I would have written that heading down. I forgot to. Anyhow, let's go ahead and we'll get this thing started up. Let's go ahead and put on the parking brake. And I don't think you have to have the mixture yet, because it's just the mixture, so I think you can do it this way. Go ahead and prime it three times. Go ahead and turn on the master switch and our beacon. Gonna go ahead and put that full rich, and we'll turn on the fuel pump, turn on the mags, and hit the starter. We got her running. We got our RPMs. I'm gonna go ahead and lean this out a little bit. I should have looked. I was keeping me to look up carb heat, and I never do. It's about 60%. We'll go ahead and turn off that fuel pump. Radio. I should have had that off, but it comes on. So Radio Master is on. We'll go ahead and turn on the pedo heat. All right. Autopilot's on GPS. I think everything else is probably pretty good right now. We guys just gotta turn on the electronics. Radio is everything. Put that on standby. Let's go ahead and we'll have to clear that. Cancel the IFR when we're on flight. I think it's runway 23. We could just use 230. It goes 229. There it goes, the 230. It's kind of weird. We kept going 229, 231. That can't be the right runway. Airport as filed. Climb and maintain 6,500. Departure is 121.0. Squawk 735. Maybe it's 5. We'll have to look. Here in a second. Alright, KOXD, selects a runway for takeoff. Yeah, it is 23. I guess that thing will change as soon as we move. Announce our taxi to it. And we have no taxi lights. Alright, parking brake is going off. Let's go ahead and taxi on over to the runway. I can't tell if that wasn't really looking to see if that dial moved or not. Well, that's still 23 is coming back this way. Perhaps I'm lost. Maybe there's the runway all the way down there. Did they actually put us? Because I was looking at, the reason I said 23 is because I was looking at a map earlier. And it looked like this took you right over to the runway. I see a runway sign over there. So maybe it was a little different than I had thought. Just see when we get over here. What's going on? Because now I saw buildings down there, and on the map there were no buildings. Unless those were just houses that I just saw. We probably use some lights in here. Where's... There we go. Let me get the yoke off. I'll put on bright. Alright, so this basically brings us to the end of the runway. Looks like we'll have plenty of runway to take off, I think, from right here. Try to slow her down. It always seems like I'm jamming the brakes, but I'm actually pumping them. Park brake is coming on. I don't think we need to go over there. I think we've got enough runway right here. And I guess we'll say that we're going out to the south. Bring up this GPS and turn off all the messages. And resize that. Alright. Just called that out. Get that off there. Landing lights. And strobe coming on. Set the flaps. As long as there's nobody out here, we can go ahead and get on out of here. I'm going to go ahead and turn that on, even though we actually need to turn it to 1200. But they'll tell us that the transponder is wrong. If we do it now, so we'll just wait. Alright. Lined up here and off we go. No, we did not go. I'm hitting the brakes. I was about to say the engine sounds weird. That's because I screwed up. I always gotta screw something up. I should have checked. Yeah, I gotta go full mixture. Engine was gonna have a problem there. Alright, now we can go. Getting ahead of myself. A little red on me. Alright, let's go ahead and get up in the air. Much better takeoff. Some of them have been really squirrely. Alright, I'm going to go ahead and retract the flaps. And you can really feel this plane moving around in the air. It's actually pretty cool, but it's a little more difficult to fly. RLR2's got us. Tune over to departure.
Cincinnati departure.
Like I said, we gotta cancel this thing. I was gonna get it. I just hate that it takes so long to do this. Now we'll cancel it. There we go. Jeez, I hate this. It takes so long. I don't know why it bothers me so much. I do know why. It takes my hands off the controls. I can't pay as much attention. Thank you. We'll put this 1200. Alright. Straighten her out here. Get that nose from coming back. Whoa, whoa, whoa. I don't know what that was all about. Sometimes if I hit the trim button while I'm moving the controls, I've noticed it. That's what happened. It did it twice there. I just happened to be turning the yoke while I hit the trim button, and it really pushed it down. That was kind of odd. All right. Tell you what. Hey, I just had it so it was trimmed and it was nosed down a little bit, and I hit it two notches and it wants to go way up. I can't seem to find the happy medium with this plane. Autopilot and master switch coming on. Alright, she's ready. Go ahead and have that follow the GPS. It's going to be a heading of about 128 degrees. Desired track. There we go. This actually had her trimmed about even right there. Trim a little more nose up here. Get her to climb. Although then it takes a bunch of clicks to get it back up. A lot of times I think this is just easier to do it. To use this. That shouldn't have sent it nose up like that. Yeah, we changed it a couple degrees, but not that much. She'll come back down here. It sounds like our engine is losing a little bit of power as well, which is never fun. See, now all of a sudden she comes falling back down. Like, come on now. Actually, I guess if it was 50 and we changed it to like 43, 7 degrees is quite a lot. But see, now she's settled back down. I think that's because of the engine power. Let's go ahead and start leaning her out. I'm not sure if we should add carb heat or what. Like I say, I need to look that up. It really sounds like our engine is losing power. We'll go full carb heat. She came up a little bit there. See, she is sounding better. There she comes back. Just gotta give her a second. But as the power comes up, the nose wants to come way up. Come on now. See, then the nose comes way down like that. It's just really hard to get it to do like it as a calm pace. Alright, like I said, we're going to level off at 6,500. We got about 100 and... I guess that's about 116, 118 miles to go. Right at about an hour. I'm going to make this a little bit bigger. Since there's nothing to see, because we're literally in the clouds... I guess it's going to be like this for a while, all winter probably. Low visibility flying. But with all that going on, let's go ahead and speed her up. Like I say, we'll level off at about 6,500, and I'll be back in just a little bit. Thank you. All right, everybody, slowing it down here. About 17 miles out. Let's go over, and we should, probably should already be descending, but let's set up ADIS real quick, which is 125.2. Switch it over and see what runway's in use.
Huntington Airport information, Quebec 1411 Zulu, wind 316 at 5.
No more altitude hold either.
Condition, ceiling 200, overcast. Temperature 62.4, altimeter
3023. Man, it was it sucks because we're straight in for 1-2 right now. I mean, come on, plane. I trimmed it down maybe 5-6 points, and she just went straight nose down. We need to go ahead and switch tanks to over to the left. Yeah, it sucks because, you know, if we were using 12, we could just come straight in. Let's move our heading on over. And switch that over to heading. We need to actually, I guess, come in from the other side. I'm not going to use the tower. We could, but I'm not going to. I cut the power, hit the trim a couple times. Look at what happens to the nose. I just don't understand why she's so kind of crazy responsive to a fault. Then the nose wants to fall again, so I gotta trim it up more. I just can't win with this plane. Don't quite understand. Now she's coming way too far nose up. I mean, I know speed plays a part in that as well. As you get faster, the nose wants to come up, but daggone. Can't seem to keep it anything constant. That's not so bad right there. If you can keep it around 400 or 500 in, then those guns keep going down. See, I don't know. Like, how do you come in at a 45 degree angle when you're coming in? Because usually you come in at a 45 here and then go. So how do you do the 45 if you're on the other side? I guess you can come into a 45 here, in which case we shouldn't have gone over yet. I didn't really think about that part. I'm not going to be able to do it exactly properly like I wanted to. Because we're too far over to the right now. See, like, how did it get down to 1,500 feet like that? And the speed didn't really increase much, and now the nose comes flying out. I haven't even touched it. The only problem is, also, we can't really call out the legs. So we'll go 209. There we go, put it about 75%. Actually, let's go to 80, because we're coming up on 4,000. We should be pretty much parallel here, or well, I should say perpendicular. Although, you see it's off by like 20 degrees. It says we're at 190, even though we have it basically almost at 210. That's off by like 20 degrees. I can't believe the wind is going to be that crazy. There's a little bit of green with all that snow. I don't know if we can see the airport from over here. By the way, we could go ahead and set the ILS for runway 30 as 108.7. Switch that over and put it in this one as well. Whoops. 108.7. Get her hold here in a second. The airport elevation is 827 feet, so I guess we, and normally we hold at about 3,000. Let it go a little bit under that. Let's go ahead and turn 119. Oh, pull back on the yoke a little bit. That nose from falling so quick on the turn. They say we'll let her go to about 2,800. Kept us a, got us a little close though. We should, probably should have gone out a little bit more. That'll be a tight turn, but that's all right. Or fall down just a little bit. I don't want to go down too much. Power's going to bring that nose up. Wow, it really brought it up. My goodness. Because we're only about 100 feet from where I want to be. Bring it down just a little bit. The nose keeps sneaking on up. Fairly stable right here. Like I said, we'll go to 2,800 and have her level off. All right, 2,800. We'll go ahead and try to hold her steady right here. And let's go full rich. Still, the airport's actually still ahead of us. Covered up by all the daggone fog and everything. Yeah, it's the only thing I don't like about flying in the wintertime. But we haven't been able to get away from the clouds. And we're in a new plane that's harder to fly. And, like, the reduced visibility just makes it even more difficult. Which is kind of fun. Kind of annoying, kind of fun. Still can't see it. Should be like right there. It's just like in that cloud. The cloud is like perfectly placed so we can't see it. And that the thing refreshed, like that cloud right there. Like, no, we're still not. It's almost like it was on purpose. We're still not going to let you see it. It can't be that below us, right? I mean, I know we're close to it. Almost on top of it. That's, well, no. I was going to say, maybe we're too on top of it, but it seems like it should be out there a little bit. Probably is just under us too much. Oh well, so we'll just go out here a little ways. Because we're about 2,000 feet above. It's going to require a bit of a tight turn. A real base leg. So we'll go at 029 here in just 1 second. I just want to get out far enough because it feels like we're higher up than I thought we would be. And we'll just switch that from GPS over to nav, by the way. So the glide slope is actually well below it. Well, I'm not sure if that actually has it. See, I don't even know if you have to actually turn this. Because normally we don't mess with it, but sometimes I get to thinking that you should mess with that. 119. See, we are coming up on it. See, I'm surprised that we're that high. Because I was going to say 3,000, but then I said that 2,000 will be better. But we're actually way too freaking high. Alright, 029. Just naturally, the nose is dipping down a little bit. I'm not going to worry too much about that. It's just dipping down on the turn, which you expect. Give me a couple notches there to help out. It still doesn't. It's off a little bit. Let's go ahead and turn 119. Sorry, yeah, 119. Wait. 299. Although, like I say, it's not totally on the mark. They're coming to the right just a little bit more. Although we're about to get... See if she won't just follow that. I don't know if she's got that or not. She should be following the ILS. Yeah, we're coming left. Alright, so we need to get down a little bit. Oh, bring down the power. She was already coming down a little bit. And when I touched that power, daggone, she really wanted to fall. We still need to get down a little bit. I want to see if she's gonna control that herself or not. Because I think we were trying to find that out in another video, if she will actually follow a glide slope or what. It had me for a little while believing that she would actually follow a glide slope. I'm going to pull back on the yoke, see if she follows this or not. Looks like we're off to the right. Problem is, you can't actually see the daggone airport and see she's getting too low. I have to pull her back up. Yeah, still can't see the airport. Trying to keep that nose up, man. But I don't want to get our speed up either. There's the airport. So we get our flaps out here in a second. So I'd actually like to be a little high, if anything, as usual. It's just you don't want to be too fast because we got, like I say, we got to get our flaps out. Few miles out, let me get that off our screen. Get myself views realigned. Alright. Autopilot. Well, I thought autopilot was good. Knocked off, it wasn't. Now it is. Bring down the power. Need to bring down our speed. Wow, she's so, like I say, she's so touchy on the controls, this plane. Some planes it feels better to be a little more touchy, this one not so much. Second notch of flaps coming out. Same time, we want to get down, but we don't want to get too slow. Alright, we're at full flaps. Make the power just a little bit to help get down, because our speed is kind of settled there at 80. I was afraid I was adding power, even though we needed to descend, but thought our speed was going to get way too low there. See, our speed gets end up in this plane ends up being really low. And we come in like that. Since it was smooth, it didn't feel too bad. It feels really slow. Like, we're right on the cusp of really stalling each time we land. Retracting the flaps. Get us off the runway here. Like a decent landing. Like I say, it's kind of odd because it feels really, really slow when we come down like that. And when we get off the power, I don't know if you should stay on the power on this thing a little bit longer because it just seems to die. Alright, parking brake is coming on, so we can stop right here. Landing lights and strobe lights can go off. I'm going to go ahead. I was going to turn the pedo off. Can't really get to it. There we go. Pedo is off. Let's bring this back to about 60. If I don't foul the plugs, I'm just going to turn these off. Parking brake is coming off. We'll go over here and park and unload this thing. This wasn't a big money maker. I know that it was only a couple grand, but it seemed like a nice kind of a short flight. I don't want to do very many long flights in this plane. I don't really like the plane for long flights. Mainly because of the way the altitude and everything. It's a little bit more difficult to do long flights for me. I got on the brakes when I was turning there. Swung it real hard. Alright, so put on our parking brake right here. Carb heat can go off. I should have put that on standby after we landed. I'm going to go ahead and turn that off. Turn all the radios and electronics off. Alright, we can go ahead, I guess, and cut the fuel mixture. Beacon can go off. Magnetos off, master switch off, so everything should be off. Air hauler has it. Alright, so we'll go ahead and unload this thing. Unload our potatoes. Finish the flight monitoring. All right. Smooth landing. Let's see. We took off at 121, landed at 229. It was actually 1 hour and 7 minutes. Takeoff fuel, 84 pounds. Landed with 50 pounds. Max altitude, 6,545 feet. Max pitch was -8.4. Max roll was -17.97. Max speed was 118.3 knots. Minimum G, 0.36. Minimum G's exceeded 0. Max G's 1.379. Max G's exceeded 0. Stall false. Overspeed false. Landing description was smooth. Gear down, of course, was true. Landed on asphalt. No damage to the runway. No damage to the plane. Came down at 92.9.8 feet a minute. Landing speed was 49.7 knots. Landing pitch -4.9. Landing roll 0.187. Landing heading 301.6. Landing wind speed 7. Landing wind direction 306. So I guess the depth's right. To land on 30. So now we're in Huntington. It's been kind of annoying. There's something wrong with Air Hauler. You see these? These are like flights to absolute nowhere. Like, you click on them, and it's really kind of frustrating. I don't... Because, like, it acts like they start from somewhere, but you can't... Like this one, KRZT. Like, you can't click on it. It's not a real flight. See, it, like, it's black, but it's not a real flight. Like, I was trying down here trying to click on this one, and there's another flight, and I don't think it... Maybe this one wouldn't get clicked either. Like, I can't... click on some of these. It's really frustrating. That one should be a real... For some reason, I can't click on this flight. Which is where we just took off of from KAXO. I don't know why, but you can't click on that flight. It's been kind of frustrating. I think there's one here at Dayton that I wasn't able to click on either. I don't know. It's kind of frustrating. We're down here in Huntington. I don't know if there's... Well, that's, man, there's a lot of flights going to Charlotte for some reason. He's another one going down to Charlotte. This one goes to Frankfurt. I thought about doing that one. Frankfurt's not too far away. 111 miles. Man, you could almost... Well, that's so heavy. I don't want to take something so heavy because it's really hard for us to fly it. I have no problem with the AI pilots flying that because they'll be fine with it. But us, not so much. We do have some heavy ones in here. That one to Frankfurt would be nice. We can't do it in an hour and 22 minutes. Plus, I gotta leave sometime today. It's Christmas Eve. I'm just kind of killing some time and doing a little flying before I go over dinner and stay over the night with some family. Anyhow, that's gonna be it for this episode, everybody. I hope you all did enjoy. Actually, let's, before we end it, look at this. We do have a lot of money, but man, this chick, she's killing us. She destroyed the plane. I repaired the plane, and then by the next day, she destroyed it. This Maya chick. Let's see if I can find out. That's the cargo. Plus, these things are weird. Like, how did Maya have all these flights in one day? Like, where was Zach that day? Why did she have all these flights? She has four flights. They each have four, but they get mixed up, and it just doesn't make any sense. I'd like to find exactly where I paid all that money. Paid like 10 grand. There it is. 10,532. The plane was 100%. She did 10. She knocked it down like 38%, I think. Because you can look in the reputation log. Yeah, well, she, I guess it was a 96 because she did 34% damage. Passengers were terrified. Like, you going on the way to Cincinnati. You can see it dropped our reputation 0.6. I don't... And I helped her out. Well, assignments is zero, or training assignment or skill assignment. She's a touchdown less landing there. She's full. So I was looking at something. Aircraft holds better. Now she's full on that. I think I upped that two. I think she had two after she did that. So hopefully that'll be better. I don't... Just... kill on the plane. Both of them have been doing damage, especially her, though. But anyway, that's going to be it for this episode. I hope you all did enjoy it. I'll catch you guys on the next flight.